Cruise ship construction is an enormous undertaking that involves thousands of decisions and logistical planning protocols that must be precisely set and coordinated in just the right order. This ship is actually built in stages, often in different locations before being put together like a jigsaw puzzle or a game of Legos. It comes together as the result of 1,000 key steps, 200,000 different tasks, and the involvement of 500 subcontractors and suppliers. According to shipyard officials, each shipyard completes the process a bit differently. Generally speaking, it depends on the size of the ship and the cruise line, but a time frame of about 1 year to 18 months is the unusual length it takes from laying the keel to the final delivery. Modern technology such as computer-aided design and modular cabins has helped to speed up the process, though designing the ship itself tends to add another year to the whole operation. It might surprise you to know that there are only 4 shipyards in operation today with the capabilities to build cruise ships. We have touched on 3 of them earlier, with Mitsubishi Heavy Industries rounding out the number. Twin Century, based in Italy, delivered its first cruise ship back in 1990 and is currently the largest shipbuilder in Europe. Family owned and based in Germany, Meyer Werft started building cruise ships in the mid-1980s. Their shipyard is in a somewhat unique location since it has no actual direct access to the ocean. All ships must be transferred via a river to the North Sea. Lastly, STX Europe, despite the name, is based in South Korea and was the yard responsible for building Royal Caribbean, Oasis and Allure of the Seas. Lightweight metals such as aluminium and high-strength steel are used in order to keep the center of mass low despite their size. The heaviest component, things like engines, propeller and fuel tanks, are located in the lower parts of the ship. And despite the top heavy appearance, weight is evenly distributed to ensure stability. The use of lightweight materials not only help to reduce fuel consumption and emission, they are more than ready for to perform in the at times challenging environment of the sea. Fiber reinforced plastic and carbon fiber, frequently used in the aerospace industry, are being considered too, since they could theoretically lessen the mass and bring down the center of gravity by reducing weight above the waterline. For me, the most surprising element of ship construction was the most of it is actually built elsewhere. The ship as a whole consists of dozens of small parts, including cabins, which are each built at an assembly line. The assembly line includes the installation of almost all passenger amenities, light fixture, wiring, power outlets, furniture, TV, beds, bathroom fixtures, and even trash cans, so that when cabins are stacked into the ship, their electrical wires and plumbing can be instantly connected to the rest of the vessels. There is little additional work that needs to be done once the cabin is loaded onto the ship, with some mega liners reaching close to 500 feet in total height, including the hidden below water section, which is roughly equal to the section above the ocean surface. Putting any cruise ship together is a masterpiece of structural engineering. The hull of the ship is the first part built, constructed on dry land, creating a base for the vessel. Ground crew and massive cranes combine to build the hull, ensuring the structure is border height, before placing the superstructure atop the hull. Many parts of the superstructure are remotely built in smaller blocks, then placed upon the hull akin to an enormous Lego construction. Shipyards traditionally include border control systems which allow work crew to build the ship, both in and out of the water. This can simultaneously test the constructed hull for watertight structure and allow the engineers to work on the underwater sections of the ship. Using man-made dam system, the shipyard can allow the team to fill and empty the construction site as and when they choose, helping create a sense of escapism and total luxury. All the major cruise lines bedeck their vessels with the finest flourishes and decor that money can buy. Employing the help of top artists and interior designers, the cruise lines ensure that their ships resemble high-end resorts rather than modes of transportation.